you. I would like to bring my group on today that we're going to be using here. These guys are really, 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 really good. They're called the Bruise Brothers. Ladies and gentlemen, come on, Bruise Brothers. Come on up. We're going to get settled in here. What we're going to do today, we're going to kind of go back in time and do a few things for you. We're going to start off doing a couple of songs that we cut in Memphis, Tennessee at one time. One of them is called We Hate School, for those who still remember. And the other one's called Lance Russell's Nose, okay? Now, if anybody wants to come down front, you know you're more than welcome to. We've got a film crew that's going to be filming this, and we're going to put it back on some of the TV shows that we're doing. We're doing a documentary of Memphis wrestling, and so hopefully this is going to be part of it. So I hope somebody will save your seat. But if you want to come down front, you're more than welcome to. But you're more than welcome to sing along with us tonight. You know, when we sing Lance Russell's Nose, the bridge is very easy. It's Lance Russell's Nose. So y'all can sing that with us. And of course, We Hate School is We Hate School, We Hate School. There you go, you got it. But we're going to do a few songs for you. And in between the songs, I'm going to tell you a little something about the ones that we're going to do, okay? Now, this first one is a song that we had out. Jerry the King Lawler were kind enough to let me cut this song back when we were doing Memphis wrestling, okay? Some of your older people remember, some of the younger people might not. But some of the radio stations here played it, and it got number one in Memphis. And I wish it got number one around the world, but we only put it out here in Memphis. But we're going to do this for you with the Bruise Brothers. This song is called We Hate School. Was kind of the glue that put everything together, Dave Brown and Lance Russell. So I went to the King and I said, King, I've got a little song that I wrote for Lance Russell. If it's okay with you, I would love to do it. And he said, okay, if that's what you want to do, we'll let you do it. And I said, okay, thank you very much. So I'm hoping I can get this right, okay?
You're awesome, Jimmy.
Thank you.
Two times.
One, two.
Jim McGuire, we wrote for the WWE, which was the WWF back then. I used to manage a guy that was originally from Memphis, Tennessee down here. His name was Wayne Ferris.
Yeah!
He was one of the Blonde Bombers down here. You remember the big Tupelo concession stand fight back in the day?
Yeah.
Well, when he went to New York, he grew his sideburns out. He had a little bit of black hair like Elvis. We put him in the jumpsuit. And Jimmy Hart, the Colonel, managed him. And he was the Intercontinental Champion for over a year until the Ultimate Warrior took our belt from us!
Yeah.
But that's okay. But we're going to do this song for you right now. It's called The Honky Tonk Man.
Yeah!
Thank you.
We're going to do a song that I wrote originally for Scary Sherry. Yeah. But later on, when she went on vacation, Vince came to me and he said, you know what? I want Shawn Michaels Shawn to sing Michaels. This oh, next yes. song. Now, believe this or not, a lot of people say if Jimmy Hart's lips are moving, he's lying, but I'm not. We've had over 5 million plays on TV and on air with this particular song over the last 30 years, because we cut this record about 30 years ago, because this is WrestleMania 33 coming up in Orlando this coming year. So this is Shawn Michaels, and we're going to attempt to do the version of Sexy Boy for Woo! Him. And y'all can sing with us. Sun Records with a friend of mine, and we cut a little song that was number 40 on the Billboard charts. It was written by Neil Young, who we met about 3 years before that in Hollywood, California, when we played the Whiskey A Go Go. But it's a little song called Cinnamon Girl. You can sing it if you like, okay?
Thank you.
go back in time for one more quick song before we bring the wrestling on, but this is a song that we cut back in 1965. It was a mega seller for us. The gentleman who produced this, well, the man who really kind of discovered this was George Klein. I know a lot of people heard of George Klein. But a guy named Chip Spillman came back to town, and after he cut this song on us, he produced the Box Tops with a letter, Sandy Posey, Born a Woman, and of course, Elvis on In the Ghetto. So, thank you guys so much for coming out on a night like this. You all know there's so much stuff going on in town today, and football tonight and everything, but it just shows you how loyal you Memphis wrestling fans really are. Yeah. Mississippi and Arkansas and Missouri, we love you so much. We've got a great show to bring to start for you, but if you want to, this was our first and only million seller record. It's called Keep On Dancing. Yeah.